it's me, Destin. So welcome to my 4th of July tradition, something I do every year. I'm out here on the Bickering Nag alone this year. Everybody else had something they had to do because the fireworks show is late. But anyway, I'm just gonna kind of take you into my tradition and show you what I do. We always try to stay close to the bank because we don't want to get near the motorized vehicle. It's kind of weird, makes you think a booger's gonna get you. But anyway, so what we do is we set up opposite from the fireworks show on the river. I take a time-lapse open shutter photography. I've always been notoriously bad at chemistry, like real bad. So this year I decided I was going to learn the chemicals and the different colors that they make for fireworks. So I researched it a little bit. So I'm gonna run through that with you. These are not pure elements that we're burning here. These are compounds created with these elements. So keep that in mind. Red is strontium. Orange is calcium, calcium salts usually. Electric white's like magnesium or aluminum or something like that. Blue, that was a pretty good one. Blue is usually copper. Green is barium. Yellow is sodium compounds. Gold is some type of iron, usually with some kind of potash or some kind of carbon in it. Purple is a combination of strontium and copper, so you got the red and the blue going together. But anyway, I hope you enjoy my pictures. I hope you think it's pretty cool. I really like it. It's one of my favorite traditions, and I do it every year. Unfortunately, the kids had to go to bed early because this year the fireworks show was too late. They really enjoy this. It's one of their favorite things, and I miss my wife out here with me this year as well. But anyway, you are getting smarter every day, and tell your friends. Have a good one. Bye. Stationary as I move his body. I can move his body in pretty much any direction.